In this video, we're going to convert moles to mass and vice versa using two examples. We can interconvert from moles to mass and from mass to moles using molar mass of that substance. In order to perform this calculation, we'll first need to know how to calculate molar mass. I'll link the video on the top if you need a refresher. Let's try out a couple of questions to see how we can convert between these two things, moles and mass. Let's look at our first question. It gives us 0.245 moles and it's asking us to find the mass of zinc. We're gonna use dimensional analysis method to solve this. So we write out what we need to find, which is the mass of zinc, equals what the question gives, which is 0.245 moles. And then we place a multiple sign and draw a line across. Place what we want to get rid of at the bottom, which is moles, and then it will cancel out like that. And then we place what we need to find on top, which is the grams of zinc. We look up the atomic mass of zinc in the periodic table and we get 65.39. So we place that next to the grams. And since it's the molar mass, it's the mass for one mole, that means it's one next to the mole. So we do the math, 0.245 times 65.39 gives us 16.0 grams. If you don't like solving using this method, just remember, if you're given moles and you need to find mass, simply multiply the given number with the molar mass. Moving on to our next and final question. This question is the reverse of the first question. It gives us the mass and it wants us to find the moles. We're going to use the same method. So we're going to start by writing out what we need to find. And then equals what we're given, 392 grams, and times, draw a line across, and then we place grams at the bottom so that we can cancel them out. And then we place mole on top because that's what we need to find. Okay, now it's time to fill in the numbers. Since we're using molar mass, which means it's the mass for one mole, so we'll place one next to mole. And then we need to calculate the molar mass of CCl4, and that's 12 plus 4 times 35.45, 12 for carbon, 35.45 for chlorine, which turns out to be 153.8 grams. We take 392 times 1 and divide by 153.8 and we get 2.55 moles. Don't forget to include the unit mole. Again, if you're not into this way of solving, all you have to remember is in going from grams to moles, all you have to do is divide the given mass with the molar mass of the compound. To recap, from the two questions we've worked on, when going from moles to mass, we multiply with the molar mass. And in going from mass to moles, we divide the molar mass. I hope the video helped you out somehow. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.